Yo, what is up, YouTube? We're the Great Picture here, DGP, back here with another episode of Patriot Keys. And yes, in this video here, we're going to talk about the post-game review, man, about the New England Patriots and the Las Vegas Raiders, man. Week three, man, it's here. It's here, and the New England Patriots got the dub. But you can look at the score, you can say it's a blow. We controlled this game from start to finish, man. We're going to get into it, man. As you already know, though, go ahead and be sure you hit that subscribe button, man. Leave a like on the video, and you know I'm here to talk about my notes, talk about the games, and play the highlights over it. So without further ado, let's get into that. So the New England Patriots won today's game 36-20. The Raiders kind of got a late touchdown at the end. So really, if you want to look at it, really 13-36. We pretty much dominated this game again from start to finish. If you look at the stats, Cam Newton only 160 yards passing. You're like, dang, it wasn't that much. Well, it was because he was there on the run game, as you can see right here. Him on the run game as well as everybody else. I think we had like eight different people tally a rush today, man. Sonny Michel had two big runs, 9 carries, 117 yards. Rex Burkhead, man, 6 carries, 49 yards, and a touchdown. Taylor, man, the undrafted free agent, man, 11 carries, 43 yards. He was the one that started the game and everything. Mike Reese earlier today said, well, not earlier today, going into this week, said that Sonny wanted to have that starting role. He's going to have a big game against the Raiders, and boy, he did. Look like he was his rookie year and everything. Made a couple good cuts. Rex Burkhead, too, we can't forget about him in the passing game on the screen. 7 catches, 49 yards, and a touchdown, which is pretty much you could say just a, you know, just a break off on the passing game. So you can kind of look at that as rushes and everything. And he made an excellent cut. N'Keal Harry had a couple catches. Burr connected a few times. Julian Edelman a few times. But it was mostly just on the run game, man. We ran the ball just basically the whole game and just dominated them from start to finish. Similar to how the Raiders did last week against against the New Orleans Saints. So let's go ahead and let's talk about this. And also another good note, Joe Thuney was the starting center today. He wasn't at left guard. We had the rookie number 71, I can't remember his name, but we had him starting at left guard today. And also Darren Waller for the Raiders, you know, he gave the Seahawks trouble. He had 17 targets yesterday, their big piece out in the passing game. He only had 2 catches, and one of those was, and he didn't get none of them until the fourth quarter, basically in garbage time. 2 catches, 9 yards, man. I believe he did draw a penalty flag, but he had no targets in the first half, man. So we did a good job locking him up. And now let's go ahead and let's talk about this game from start to finish. So first quarter, we get the ball first, man. We go ahead 3 and out. Then the Raiders get the ball. You know, calls an incomplete. We couldn't get the sack. Ends up having on the punt. Then after that, we punt again. So the first couple drives, kind of filling out process, was a grinding out game. Defenses were stepping up. However, Raiders start driving down the field on their second drive. And then, however, they decide to run to the right, to the left, I should say, run to the left. Jacobs runs. Gets a peanut punch by Calhoun. We ended up recovering it. It looked like that Jacobs recovered it at first when he did lose possession, but the ref saw something else. So, hey, shout out to the refs on that. So now we go right there, and I'm, you know, third drive of the game. I'm like, all right, maybe the Patriots got a turnover. They were backed up into their own red zone. Now let's get it going, man. And Cam Newton, a couple plays later, throws an interception. Basically, him trying to make a play, should have threw it away or even scrambled for a little bit, but he was trying to make a play. I think it was like on third down 2, just threw it in. Terrible pass, man, which ends up giving them a field goal. We end up giving them a field goal. So now we're going to move into the second quarter. Then a whole different game, you know what I'm saying? We get Taylor out on the stretches, out on the tosses. He's getting out, getting 5-6 yards of carry. We even get a first down pass to Julian Edelman. Then also too, on one of the toss plays with Taylor, we get a 15-yard face mask helps us out. Zuber, the wide receiver promoter off the practice squad, he gets the a 19-yard wide receiver reverse. And then we end up getting a field goal. Then defense comes around, and Chase Winovich gets a Tuck Rule-esque fumble, able to force that. So now we get the ball again and again. We're just feeding Taylor. We're feeding Burkhead. They have a big drive. Izzo drops a touchdown, man, in the side of the end zone. We have to settle for 3, man. Then the defense just, again, just locks up. So, you know, now we're moving on again. So it's kind of a slow game, but then eventually, you know, we just kept running. The run game got going. We hit Burr for a big game on a fake screen pass. And then Rex Burkhead with an amazing cut going upfield, man, to get that receiving touchdown, man. And so that go ahead settles it right there. And then from there, we started getting rolling, man. Stephon Gilmore did give up a defensive pass interference going into the second half, which, you know, gave them a field goal. It's because he got beat. You know, it's one of those things where it's like, he's going to catch it. Let me just take the penalty now and all that. So we gave him, and we ended up, I'm sorry, not a field goal. Derek Carr actually threw a dime to, I think, to one receiver. It was ruled a touchdown. Was came back, and they ended up throwing it to a tight end. So that's how we gave up a touchdown. Sorry, not a field goal. I thought it was going to be a field goal, but it was actually a touchdown. So now we're going into the half. was it 13-10? Yeah, I think it was 13-10. And so now we're coming out of third quarter. Raiders get the ball. We hold into a three and out. Not three and out. You know, Edwards gets a big catch. They're driving down the field. They're forcing to take checkdowns and everything. And then it ends up going wide left. So then the Patriots get the ball again. We're just running the football the whole game. And that's pretty much the whole second half. As Michelle got going, we had some Taylor get some key stuff in. Cam made the key passes and everything. And we kept going, you know, just methodical offense, driving down the field, getting scores and everything, taking up a lot of clock too. Again, the defense was bending but not break. I'll tell you, the big point was Cam Newton threw the bird for like a 20-yard pass, and then I think it was on third down. Cam Newton had an amazing scramble, get us down the field, which then led to a Rex Burkhead run, which gave us a touchdown, but Nick Folk misses the extra point. Raiders hit the ball following that. Calhoun with a strip sack in the end zone after a great coverage on the kickoff. We pretty much forced them to like the 10 with the, and then with them having a block in the back, they had to snap the ball like the 2-yard line. We get Derek Carr in the end zone. Sack him. At first, they ruled it a safety, but under further review, we forced the fumble. Derek Wise recovered it in the end zone, and it's a touchdown. So that kind of broke the game over from there. Then after that, Darren Waller finally got his first catch. And, you know, after that, was just, you know, waiting for the clock to go, and I'm just running the clock out. So looking at this game, man, this team actually did some pretty amazing things, man. Again, like I said, this game is going to be a dog fight. It's going to be a dog it out type game. That's what this team is going to be like this year. It's going to be a dog it out type game, dog fight type game. I'm proud of what we accomplished today, man. I really don't got much to say about this game. It was more so just us running the clock out, just feeding the run game. Defense stepped up. Stephon Gilmore has 3 defensive pass interference calls, which is more than what he had last year. He only had 1 last year, so we got to monitor that. And, you know, I didn't make a video on this, but David Andrews, our center, the reason why I said Thuney starting at center is because David Andrews was put on IR for at least 3 weeks. So Thuney's probably going to be our center for the next 3 weeks. And again, a lot of bounce attack today. We haven't had some passes, had some run. If you look at the way the weeks has gone, week one, we were run heavy. Week two, we were pass heavy. Week three, we were kind of balanced. So now we got the Kansas City Chiefs coming up. Let's see how that goes. But again, with this game, if I had to get my grades, Cam Newton gets a B+. The running backs get an A+. The offensive line gets an A+. Shout out to the O-line. They held it down today. Receivers, they get a B. Did a decent job. Our defensive line, I'm going to actually give them a B+ today. We actually got some pressure. We got some defensive stuff. Shout out to Calhoun and everything. Secondary, I'm going to go ahead and give them a B as well. It was pretty decent. He had a couple other drop INCs that we should have had. And linebacker core, I'm going to give them a B as well, man. They did a pretty decent job. So MVPs of this game, man, Rex Burkhead, man, and the offensive line, they did their thing. Again, the Patriots go 2-1. We take on Kansas City next week, and can't wait for that game, y'all. So this your boy, DGP. Like, subscribe, comment. Check out next time, y'all. Peace.
I ain't never ran from a no, I ain't never. If I did, cut my legs out right now. I ain't never been with the talk, snitch talk, always talking about his fault. Nope. Yeah, I'ma stand up, got my bands up. You don't wanna see me pissed off. Real talk. Never tell a lie to a dog. Nope. When it come to them, you gotta play it out. And I never ever let get to me.
Why not?
Ain't worth my energy.
What you had to do?
Cut them off, make them feel it. I ain't dealing.